How are you today?
Good.
Okay. Today we will talk about cooperative learning. At the beginning, I want to explain why cooperative learning is very important. As we know, with the increasing number of immigrants moving to America, the education of culturally diverse students has become a focus. The education need to have a more effective teaching method to deal with the curriculum design to deal with the ESOL program. I believe the cooperative learning is very suitable for ESOL program in America. And now, before I want to introduce GSOL, someone is confused about that word, but I want you identify before you learn the GSOL. What do you think is cooperative learning?
Okay. Working together as a group?
Correct. Okay, anything else? Okay.
Kind of people coming together and using different aspects and then like bouncing the ideas off of each other to come up with one formal idea.
Definitely.
I think of it as a community of everyone in the classroom, everyone chipping in where they could, everyone giving their knowledge and perspective, helping everyone else figure out how they got to that conclusion, just like everyone just melting.
Correct. So the cooperative learning is a successful teaching method occurring in a small group, using many different activities to improve the understanding of some subject. Each member of the group needs to be accountable for their own learning, but also help their teammates to complete an assignment. All the students complete an assignment until all members can understand the subject, definitely. So just the cooperative learning is a group work, not individual work. This is the general definition of cooperative learning. Now I will introduce one of cooperative learning approach, GSOL. The GSOL is a group method. So they use the base group and the S-group group. And now this one is a base group. This the same color is the S-group group. So students can be organized to the base group, and then students can be reorganized to the S-group group, containing one members from the base group. Are you clear there? So these are the two groups, but the base group, S-group group, containing each member from the base group. If you are confused that, and later we will create this GSOL classroom later. Okay, now we will practice the GSOL activities in this classroom. And now I need you have a number counting. For example, up four. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Clear? Okay, from this side, and one, okay, you can, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4,
keep going.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3
all together.
Oh, remember your base.
Oh.
So you gotta zoom one
okay.
Four.
You,
you
need
guys
to
are 1, 2,
member,
yes.
Member one,
yes.
Base group.
One,
my whole center group.
You
one,
have
two, four. You guys
one.
Are all gonna be a group.
Okay.
Okay.
You're gonna have 2 ones and 2 twos.
Okay.
Okay. Everybody in the center, join it.
Okay.
You guys are a group. You're good.
Yeah, we're good.
You guys are a group. I see 1, 2, 3, 4. Beautiful.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay,
Chris, we're ready.
Okay, and. And now our base group forming. Later I wanna organize the expo group. So I wanna all one and sit here.
Not yet.
Oh.
In a minute.
Okay.
All ones will sit there.
All one and sit here.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yes.
Which is one?
Yeah, she's the one.
The other is we.
Oh, so you want them all right there
yeah.
Now?
I want all of one, number one, is sit here.
Yeah.
I want expert group to organize the expert group one.
Yeah.
In a minute.
In a minute.
All ones will be there, right?
Yeah.
Where
but
will twos go? Where do you want the twos?
Two and the stay here.
Okay, twos will be here.
Yeah.
Where do you want the threes?
Three and then there.
Threes will be here.
Yeah. And
where do you want the fours?
Four is here.
Fours will be there.
Yeah, and the five is here.
We're going to
have
to let's put the fives up front. Okay. Ones, raise your hand.
Okay.
You're going there.
Yeah.
Twos, raise your hand. Here.
We're doing it now?
Yes.
Okay.
Threes, raise your hand.
I'll be back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here.
Hello.
Fours, raise your hand. There.
Bingo.
Fives, raise your hand.
There's no five.
Threes are here.
Only fours.
We only did four.
Yeah.
If you're playing at certain people are absent or extra, like
having that flexibility and just on the fly, like, okay, let's do it this way.
So true.
Yeah.
I also think it's
because
I don't know, maybe this is just me, but to tie back to the visual learning, I think it's important to, you know, how the group says materials, how to go over materials, like to have a bank where the groups can have, like, make little journals that are quick so that they can write things and know that, hey, this is for this class, this is for this.
So there's less, like, transfer of material, less time with it.
Yeah, so it's like this, we are together here, go pick up your journal that we maybe made together. You
know, really like that. So it's
just like it helps manage
students,
and it helps manage the teacher reading later,
because
we can't forget that teacher does have to eventually.
So how would we write that in like one
general? I would say produce an environment for learning, like with materials.
Streamline the process.
Streamline.
What do you
think out of here?
I'm just trying to, like, catch up with you guys. It went straight from materials. And I'm just confused that was, but I'm getting it.
Yeah, I mean, essentially we're just trying to think of, like, if you were teaching and you wanted to do cooperative learning, how would you manage your, like, what things would you do to manage your classroom as you were doing cooperative learning as a teacher, right? So we're thinking of, like, using quiet signal, maybe flipping the light, maybe having a journal where you have to pass the papers around there, when it just opens up, writes, and you throw, like, time savings as well, things like that. And then if you keep on, there's a whole bunch of great ideas on that. I know he said the timer, which he's easier. Which he has, you know. Which he's using up there, which is great. Yeah.
What do you guys think? A sponge activity. It's time.
Complete to finish the task first.
Yeah, so is it just other tasks that they have to figure out?
Like, if someone goes too fast, like, instead of having nothing to do, having something else.
They should have something else to do. But, I mean, I get what they're saying, but I don't understand what. Like, what's an example? Could someone give me an example of this one?
I mean, it's basically like, I don't know, because it's like a test, for example. Well, not really, but I'm going to just use it. It's like if someone finishes their test first, it's like, they're just there waiting on everybody else to finish their test so they can do something. But like you would try to, I don't know if it's saying like it wants you to do something so they're not wasting time.
Yeah, that's what it's saying.
Okay, so
that's doing.
Oh, so
it's, what's an example of something you
could do?
Traditional method
of doing something like this. And she said, if you finish, go on to part B. If you don't, it's okay. But if you guys are done, don't just.
I didn't know.
Yeah, no. Is that what you're thinking?
No, but, well, like, now that she, like,
the only reason I know is because Dr. Reed literally used it in the last week for us.
I don't know.
We
don't get it.
What's that?
Yeah.
Okay, remember we were doing the presentation. Not together. We came up with a presentation on the psychologist. And she said, we had an hour. But if we finish early, there's an extra part.
Last
what's that?
Thursday.
I think it was like,
what would you guys do if there was a problem? Like if that was a fight, or a disagreement, or conflict? Alright. Yeah, like what if one just doesn't do their work? Like, have you ever had someone that didn't do their work?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I just would let my teacher know and be like, okay, this person's not doing much. Either that teacher would either kick them out of the group and maybe have them do like a separate assignment to, if they can't work with anybody, and have them do like their own assignment and they have to work by themselves because they can't work in a group. Or they would have them.
We did the more time. Okay, it's time to move to your face group. Remember your face group?
Hi guys.
Hi.
Much love. Hey, much guys. Just take your
mouth off.
You make room for the good.
And now you can share the learning from the expert group in your Facebook. You have 2 minutes to share it.
Per person?
Just
or total?
For total.
So it's about 30 to 40 seconds of a share per person.
How to manage the cooperative
That was about 30 seconds. You're saying for the next person?
Yeah. Okay. So I want the presentation for each group.
Who shared? Raise your hand.
Work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Only one shared. They have to have more time here. Okay. Number two needs to share.
Oh.
And then there's time. And
interpersonal skills.
Right now, going off top.
In conclusion, there are some great challenges for managing the cooperative learning. In the process of cooperative learning, the teachers need to develop some skills in managing the classroom effectively. For example, they need to help manage the noise, attention, materials, energy, and so on. Like in Chinese classroom, teachers how to control all the classroom because this is big class. There are 50 students in the class. So how to control the voice of students in the class? The teachers will do just clapping the table or throw the chalk This is just the cruel punishment, right? So throw the chalk to the student who speak in the class. And any other way, the teachers will say, please look at the blackboard. Please look at the blackboard to get the student's attention. Or the Chinese teacher will, 安静,请安静, just be quiet. Or some teachers just say, 闭嘴, shut up.
Yeah, but not
literally, it comes interaction, right? So I cannot stop students talking. I need to encourage you to interact with each other more. So how to keep the voice, noise in the proper 8 levels in the class. This is important. Now and I have hand out the evaluation for your peers, and now you can evaluate the classroom performance of yourself and your teammates. Yes.
Okay.
This is teammate, is your base teammate.
Oh, is it one for you?
Yeah, it's really a really unique idea, which I feel like would have only come about probably.
I don't think I would have come up with that on my own.
No, I would never have ever thought, oh, we'll just be doing it now. It's fine. No, actually, we solved it.
Write down your name and your teammate's first name.
What's your name?
Oh my god, those in the right order.
So you can apply other techniques into your learning, like three-step interview or three-bit interview, and so you can practice in your future learning and your future career. Any questions about the cooperative learning? I feel about that. Talk about how to manage the cooperative learning. How to manage the voice, manage the attention, manage the materials, how to keep the students' energy in the appropriate level. And so, could you be clear about that? Okay, thank you.